Welcome to another episode of series Gardens of India and vegetables, specifically vegetables of India in Texas. Today we are covering the Hanuman Temple's vegetable garden. As you guys know, we have a huge Hanuman Temple here in Texas, Dallas, Texas, Frisco, Texas, and we are all volunteers at the temple, and we have a nice volunteer garden, temple vegetable garden, where we use whatever vegetables that come from here for Annadhanam and all of that on Saturdays. Before COVID times, where we used to have every Saturday Annadhanams, now we also use it for in the canteen for sambar rice and all of these other items that volunteers make and sell in the canteen area, so that we can get some funds to the temple. So I will go through the vegetables that we have grown here this year. Every year it's a very huge garden. Why? Because there's a lot of volunteers who come during their free time and spend time over here and grow vegetables and make this like a nice farmland. This year, because of COVID, we've had issues where we had very few volunteers who came to help, but there are a few dedicated ones who've been doing this as to continue the garden. So let's look at our Dallas Hanuman Temple, Karya Siddhi Hanuman Temple vegetable garden in our series of Vegetables of India.
Here is our temple. As you see, it is the front part of the temple construction is finishing, but this is our huge Karya Siddhi Hanuman Temple, and Shilpis are working over there, and this is our temple land, and we have our this is our organic garden, where they have written that Hanuman organic garden, there is magic in this soil. So they have fed up to 2,000 people or more on a given day during Annadhanam times with the vegetables that come from here. So it is very amazing, magical garden, because the crop that comes out of this garden is simply amazing. And for something like that in Dallas, Texas, is needs a lot of volunteers work and help. So we are here today to talk to Shivaji, who is a volunteer who helps in this garden. And we will go through all the vegetables that are there currently. And we will also post some of the harvest pictures from before, so you can get an idea of what simple work from the soil can do wonders, and how it will do wonders, and how you can also grow your own food and get inspired by it. Let's enter the garden. So there is a small gate over here. So normally these are all very well. This is like lemongrass up here at the front of the gate. So it's nice, nice aroma. So we have a small gate up here. And there's a small, our Swamiji Sri Ganapati Sachidananda Swamiji's initiation to have a vegetable garden, and he encourages all of us to grow the garden and have organic vegetables which are very healthy. And he always mentions that what you eat is what you are. So it's interesting how we have adapted that rule and started building our own yards. So as you saw in our series, we have a lot of series coming up on the vegetables, and most of them are from my yard, and I live just across the street over here. So it's very interesting how we are all benefiting, and a lot of community folks are benefiting with this extra amazing growth. And I think it is all Sri Swamiji's magic that happens in this yard. It gives such amazing vegetables which we use for Annadhanam as well as canteen. So for a canteen to run with some of the vegetables that are coming from here is big. On any given day we have around 500 people or more in the canteen for the weekend. So for one vegetable to help, like surakai or something to help for the food, is really amazing. We will now talk to Shivaji. We will enter the temple garden. Nice gate, so they can eliminate any of these big animals entering, because it's not guarded by anything. So, Jai Gurudatta Shivaji, how are you?
Welcome. Yeah. Welcome to.
Thank you for letting us shoot the vegetable garden today. I know it's tough during COVID times, but thank you for coming and helping us today. Yeah. So, if you can just tell me, I know there's a lot of surakai plants over here. Yes. So, how many plants are here, Shivaji?
So, didn't count it, but it's around 30 plants.
30 surikai plants we have. Excellent. So, and how long have you been doing the vegetable gardening?
So it's from almost...
How long has this garden been here, Shivaji?
Yeah, it's around 5 to 4 years. So, which you know, we all know that this land is very different than our other agriculture lands. So, all these lands, we are prepared the soils with Apaji blessings.
So, you all dug this and added lot of other all the manure and everything, and you all made this land specifically for the yard.
Yes.
It is like a huge yard if you look at it. So, we will talk to Shivaji because he does a lot of composting and a lot of, important things that go for the plants. That's why these plants are able to grow this good and give so much yield. So we'll talk about the plants first and then talk about the things he puts, soil and all the things he puts in it. Mm-hmm. So Shivaji, over here we have around 5 plants of surakais. I've always seen these with a lot of surakai. I think he just harvested some, but you still have a bunch of them. Let me say, just this patch would have given you more than 20 pounds of surakais?
Yeah, we have a lot more inside.
Let me just walk by. So, they have used simple, this is all recycled wood. That is, I think, the pallets that come from stonework that we have been doing. Mm-hmm. So, they have used that as the trellis and this orange netting thing. So, if you see, he has put some taro root plants up here. And this is all over their surakai patch. And this is all surakai patch, and they have some green plants up here. And he also is the originator of tummi plants in Dallas, I would say, because we have gotten a lot of tummi plants for Lord Ganesha from this garden, and a lot of people have bought them from here.
We have ash gods as well here.
Huh?
We have ash gods.
We have Gumadkai, that is called the ash god over here. And this is actually the ash god patch. And if you look, there are a lot of ash gods. And he told me as soon as I came, this patch has produced so many ash gods. So I haven't seen any yet in the Dallas area, but this is the Gumadkai, the white ash god, which is very famous and very healthy. And many people use this during Guru Pravesham in India. So that's how this is famous, but they use it in dishes also for sambars and everything. So do you put anything special over here in this patch?
So this is like a forest agriculture method, which is used to follow in India. So that's why we didn't trim this. As per Swamiji instructions, we need to, you know, give a lot of space to all the creatures. So that's why we gave the freedom for them.
To grow.
They're growing as in forest.
Yeah, so it's like growing these vegetables in forest. And they do maintain to make sure no insects are there. But they work in this area. So if you see, it is not a very nicely kept. So don't think that, hey, there are a lot of weeds over here. What type of a garden is this? No, this is the way we wanted to do. And that is the method that Shivaji is saying that was encouraged by Swamiji, because all the jivas should live happily is the concept. So if you see this, there's so many flowers for this Gumadkai over here. So ash god, and so many blooms up here for that. Excellent. And there's so much of bee activity over here. And there's this tummipu plant over here. He has propagated this one plant to so many of us, and all of us have it in our garden and yard. And there is a couple of bonsai plants also over here. We put it outside for it to be watered and planted. So it's interesting. And a few flowers, because we did not go into the flower area. There is turmeric up here, which they use. And there's some ajwain, and again this is another surakai patch. And they leave some of these surakais out in the yard so that bunnies and animals can eat it instead of bugging the plants. It's a very interesting concept to understand, because this is a huge surakai and there are a lot of them around, you will notice, and they've been doing that. There's a moringa plant up here that is in the ground, and also some dosakai coming up here. So if you notice what they've done, because they've used plastic buckets to save the plant from like bunnies or any of these squirrels that are going to cut the stem out of it. So this is just two plants up here, and it's interesting how we grow. So Shivaji, even this tree is taken over the surakai. Yeah. See, we have some surakais up here. They use these ladders to cut the vegetables. So see, there's one right up there. You're going to climb and show us the sorakais.
Yeah,
so it is like just like how you have in the forest, right? This is how people used to actually grow vegetables and get them. So see, this is a huge sorakai up here. This is very good.
Yeah.
So do you put any special, like Shivaji is also famous for the Jeevamritam is what is called, correct Shivaji?
Yes, Jeevamritam.
So he also helps a lot of us with this buckets of Jeevamritam, and it's interesting concept, and I would love for him to tell. And he uses this big bucket up here to mix and do. So Shivaji, what do you use in Jeevamritam? What is the Jeevamritam method?
Jeevamritam, it's introduced by Subhash Palekar. It came from our Vedic farming. So we are using completely coming from the nature. Whatever we are getting from the nature, we're using it for them. So we are collecting cow dung and cow urine, cow milk, and the soil which we are collecting from the ground of the tree.
Mm-hmm.
So, and jaggery and besan powder, which helps to be, you know, grow the all jivas on Jeevamritam.
Okay.
So whenever we put the Jeevamritam for the plants, it attracts the earthworms.
Okay.
When we are trying to attract the earthworms, earthworms is a great concept, and they are very friendly for the farmer. They will dig around the
plant and let the water go in. Yes, very good.
So it will help to grow the plants. It will give all the manures, whatever they want to, plants want.
So how many times, is it batches that you use, Shivaji, for the Jeevamritam?
Yeah, usually we give 20 days for each batch.
Each batch. For every 20 days, you give them that.
Yeah.
So you pre-mix the concentrate ahead of time, and then you give that to the plant.
Yeah.
I mean, you mix it with water and give that.
Yeah,
so it actually, he even shares that with some of us. We also got it, and the whole concept, he had sessions up here. Shivaji has had sessions up here to show how to do this Jeevamritam. He gets the cow dung and cow urine from the local farms up here, and there are some Telugu farms. They help us out. Here it's a different kind of sorakai. If you look, I would say this is a bottle guard patch, huge patch.
This is lady.
Thank you. So this is the Beerakai plant. If you notice, each one is very healthy. And how many plants of Beerakai we have, Shivaji?
So we have around 15.
15. So this is the Beerakai and Sorakai patch of, we'll go inside. First we started over here and then we came here.
So
and look at the Tummi plants up here. Shivaji, you have something to talk about this Tummi plant patch over here?
Yes, actually, if you don't find bees on this earth, at least 12 years, there is no creature on this earth. These bees will be help lot for the incarnation of all the generations, all the jivas in the earth. When you put these flower beds in between the veggies or fruit, It helps for the pollination. So we no need to do anything for manual pollination. Excellent. It helps for that. If you see, we have a lot of them.
I see that there are a lot of such patches around the yard. Yeah. And with the vegetables and this, so it's much easier. So if you look, this is another sorakai patch. You would say, why so many sorakais? Because that is one of the vegetables that we use in the temple for sambar and all of it. So this is an initial harvest of just today's harvest that he's picking up today. So if you look at it, the number of birakai, he's still not done. The number of birakais and sorakais and dosakais are a lot. And we do, like I said, they did leave a lot of them for the animals, small animals to eat. So we have, this is the sorakai patch. Now we will go inside, just go to the bigger patch of sorakais, birakais and dosakais. Birakai patch, this is the ridge guard. You see so many, but the plants are like, you know, 8 or 9 up here. If you look at the bottom, it is all empty, but they have gotten a lot of birakais out of this. And he comes and maintains it. Now it is almost at the end of the birakai season. So you see some of the plants drying up, but they have left a lot of the birakais for seeds, right, Shivaji, right now?
Yeah, we have enough for seeds.
Yeah. So it's very interesting patch, I'm telling you, very small. And we have some gumadakai over here. One second. I am actually walking inside another patch of ours, which has... See all the sorakais up here. It's a feast to eyes to see such amazing Indian vegetables farm, I would say. And it's not one person's effort. It's a lot of volunteers' effort. People come here, do seva in the temple. And some of them spend a lot of time over here to help the garden.
As you see the backdrop, I have the huge Kari Siddhi Hanuman temple. So we are blessed by Lord Hanuman with this beautiful garden where we can do seva. If you want to volunteer, please sign up. Now is not the time during COVID, but after COVID you can always volunteer a few hours over here and benefit and do seva and feel happy that you're doing your own farming here too, if you don't have a area where you can farm. So thank you so much for seeing this episode and liking it and subscribing to it. Thank you very much. And until another episode, thank you.